In Tanzania, drone startup companies are finding real business applications for consumer drones. These local startups are filling a niche, providing fast and affordable surveying services that are traditionally done by manned aircraft in other parts of the world. One of the first people to see the potential for drones in Tanzania was Freddie Mbuya, founder of Uhuru Labs, an organization that helps local entrepreneurs.
This was the first one which I built and could do autonomous flight. And it was had a GoPro on the front and could take relatively good video.
Uhuru in Kiswahili means freedom or independence. It has no funding, but the idea is it's supposed to be a space and a place where people can do innovative things and perhaps make money. The goal is to push the Tanzanian technical envelope. I mean, currently, I think the best use case for drones in Africa is for land survey. Without a doubt, from the public good point of view, land survey. But I think, as is with many technologies, you have to look at it in a regionally relevant context. So drones are definitely allowing us to leapfrog past traditional technologies. And it's being done out of necessity.
In Swahili, we call it Mwanza drone. Mwanza is the Swahili word representing bamboo. So this is bamboo drone. Okay, my name is Bornlove. First of all, I'm working with Open Map Development Tanzania to create a map for different kind of activities, primarily for humanitarian assistance for the mapping.
This is Tanzania made drone exhibiting the Lake Victoria Challenge to prove what we can do using the local tools that you see. We have the bamboo, already brought, we took it from the bamboo right there. And these electronics we came with from Dar es Salaam. And these 3D printed parts plus battery and the electric autopilot, electronic speed control, receiver, telemetry radio, GPS and all kind of wiring things we came with from Dar es Salaam.
We built it 2 days ago with 2 hours on the workstation, and now it's flying. You have the props and motors and the flight control, receiver, GPS, powering system. It can be about $150. Bamboo is available for free.
This bamboo drone is a proof of concept, but Bornlove plans to mount a camera on it for future imaging applications.
It's awesome, guys. Wow.
I can't believe it. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Bornlove was demonstrating his bamboo drone at the Lake Victoria Challenge, a drone summit on the shores of Lake Victoria, organized by the World Bank and the government of Tanzania. The lake's islands are hard to access by road and boat, so drones could be useful for transporting lightweight goods. Wingcopter, from Germany, was one of a handful of European companies that brought cargo drones to the event. But for most of Tanzania, cargo transport isn't the greatest need. Leika Tingitana, managing director of Tanzania Flying Labs, is helping local drone startups and doing community outreach. During the Lake Victoria Challenge, Tanzania Flying Labs held drone trainings and demonstrations at local schools to help inspire the next generation of drone entrepreneurs. Leika says that rather than cargo, mapping is likely to be the next big application for drones.
You cannot do anything without mapping. What you want to do is not only create highly accurate, cloud-free, high-resolution maps, but you also want to create digital terrain models, for example, so that you can do flood modeling. And one of the best ways to do that is to use drones.
On Zanzibar, an island off the coast of Tanzania, annual floods can be very disruptive, especially to the students at the State University of Zanzibar. They've formed their own startup called Drone Wings.
My name is Abdulrahman Muhammad Hafif. I'm the co-founder of Drone Wings. We are a drone startup company that uses drones for social good. We are at Kibonde Mzungu. This area, during the high season rainfall, it is affected by floods. That is the road that connects us to go to the university. And it usually takes 35 to 20 minutes to go to the university. When the road is flooded, we take 3 to 4 hours to reach to town.
Drone Wings took aerial images of the flooded road and shared them with government agencies.
Right now, the road is being reconstructed, and we expect that on the next heavy rainfall, this area won't be flooded and we can go to the university using the same road as usual.
So you can look. If you want to see.
Zanzibar's university, which has an active drone lab, would be a great place for these eager students to begin their studies. Now the roads are open, the skies are clear, and Tanzania's drone industry is ready for liftoff.